Hello and greetings from Iceland. I decided to make this video about a subject that is in general on its own, not particularly noteworthy, but we are however living through some strange times now here in Iceland. And I always raise my eyebrows when it comes to news about Vatnajökull glacier, like the news yesterday or this glacial flood. So I'm gonna use the chance now and tell you what's going on, explain it a bit and the bigger picture. But Vatnajökull is not just the biggest chunk of ice in Europe. Under it, we have some of our biggest volcano systems, like Bárðarbunga, the hot spot under Iceland. Then we have Öræfajökull, rising over 2000 meters over the ice cap of Vatnajökull. And Öræfajökull has been showing some signs of unrest for the last few years. Grímsvötn is also nearby, or Iceland's most active volcanic system, literally just a ticking time bomb. But we know it now that the Grímsvötn caldera, which is under ice, is almost full of water, and shortly after the water discharge, we do often get these explosive glacier eruptions that airliners really hate. Lots of ash and the whole package. So maybe we should just be grateful for the ice there that is covering approximately 8% of my country, and its weight and mass is holding back volcanic activity. But our glaciers are shrinking though, and as scientists have stated often before, the deglaciation will not only lead to land rise, but increased volcanic activity as well. So, I have videos online about some of those systems under the glacier, and I will make more of them in future, so I'm not going into the details here and now. But this is however a good opportunity to show you this interesting phenomena that's hard to find elsewhere, or the origin of the glacier flood that occurred yesterday. Vatnajökull holds many secrets under the ice cap. There are plenty of hot areas there, constantly melting the ice, and that has led to the development of large pockets of water beneath the ice, which cause glacial lake outbursts. And there are two such pockets of water close to Grímsvötn, and one of them broke free yesterday. But that's nothing new. They do so every 2 years or so. So the so-called Skaftárhlaup, as we call them here, are floods from those two pockets of water. This time, the flood is believed to originate in the Western Depression. Floods from there are usually smaller than those originating from the Eastern one, and sometimes they discharge at once, like in 2018, and that can mean that we can lose some land by the river, roads, bridges, and we might have to close down the ring road for a while until the worst is over. But as I said, in this case, it's just a smaller one so far. The other one might follow, but still this is nothing serious. The Civil Protection Agency has however declared a level of uncertainty, meaning that monitoring has been increased. And there is smell of sulfur in the air, so it's not good to hang around the river Skaftá for too long. So overall, this is just an annual thing that I would usually not pick up as a subject for a video, but I do admit that I did check the earthquake graph for Vatnajökull a few times yesterday. And the thing is that our experts have Grímsvötn under constant surveillance. And those water pockets that are discharging now, they are only about 20 kilometers from the Grímsvötn volcanic system. So since the situation is a bit hectic, one might say that there is a chance that this might trigger something else. But please note that I'm not making any forecasts now. I'm just saying for myself that I'm a bit more on the lookout when Vatnajökull shows some signs. And I'm also a bit frustrated because I really need so much footage from the glacier in 4K quality to use as a B-roll for some of my videos. So if the next eruption in Iceland will take place in Vatnajökull, it's gonna mean problems that I won't fix with a drone. And finally, I want to mention the earthquakes that we see north of the glacier Vatnajökull, just by Lake Askja. Öskjuvatn, or a lake that was formed in a huge eruption in the year 1875 and left us with the deepest lake in Iceland. So I've been thinking about to go up there for some footage before the winter because I think I might need it someday, sooner or later. And those of you who are looking at the seismometers on a regular basis, you might have noticed that this has gone on for a long time. So something is brewing down there. But when it goes off, it's of course impossible to say. I just know that the more I use my channel to follow up what's happening out in my country, the more I learn about how little we know. And as for the ongoing flood, this is just one of those little features with Iceland, pockets of water up on a glacier. That's just Iceland. But a fine reminder though, to stay awake, because sooner or later the powers under the glacier will once again tease us and show us who's the boss. And with that, I'm sending you cool regards from Iceland, the home of the hottest glaciers in the world.